Welcome back to Alliances Heroes, where heroes in business align. To be part of our super community and find out more about Alliances, visit www.alliances.com. Now, back to our super host, David Kogan, founder of Alliances.
Another incredible show, because remember, it's these builders that are heroes. It's the ones that employ others, the ones that create, the ones that build, the ones that mentor, and the ones that help our community. That's what it's all about. That is what today's hero is. Later on in the show, we have the co-founder of Vintage Race Car Company and Grand Prix of Scottsdale, Jackie G. You could reach him at GrandPrixScottsdale.com, Jack Gee, and again, doing so many things and stuff, so make sure you check them out. Let's talk about our first hero, though. I hope he has brought some samples to look at, because he is the chairman and CEO of Molina Fine Jewelers and also Black Star and Frost, America's first jeweler since 1810. Al Molina, and you could reach him at MolinaFineJewelers.com. Of course, we'll also have it on our website, Eliances.com, where we'll have the link. Now, Al, you are an 11th generation fine jeweler. I mean, is that possible? Your family dates back to 1634 Milan, Italy. Now, did you choose to go into the family business, or was like this something like, hey, you have no choice. We've had so many generations in it. You're just, it's in your blood.
On March 2nd of 1967, I turned 8 years old. And instead of my parents picking me up at school, it was my grandfather who picked me up at school and said, congratulations, you're going to learn the trade. So I started on the bench on March 2nd of 1967. My grandfather took a penny. Penny used to be made out of copper, if you remember. And the copper and gold have the same malleability. And I worked on that penny for 4 or 5 hours every day. And I hated penny. I still dislike, I don't want to like to use the word hate, but I dislike pennies tremendously. Absolutely. I had no option whatsoever.
Now, Al, you are, I mean, you're a celebrity. You are the most well-known person within the jewelry industry, and you've helped so many, and you've done so many things in the community. Tell us about the historic Archduke Joseph Diamond. Now, this is the world's, right, 12th largest perfect diamond, type 2A white diamond. I mean, I don't know a whole lot about diamonds, but tell us about it.
So, you know, I've been very blessed. I mean, we have a great community of jewelers in this state of Arizona. I've served as president of the Arizona Jewelers Association. I've served as vice chairman of the Jewelers of America, and I have colleagues. These are all colleagues and friends. I'm an open book when it comes to what works, what doesn't work. And I've been very blessed to actually be recognized as I have. But it's all about work, and it's all about our own our community. It's about our ability to help each other. Now, the Archduke Joseph Diamond I purchased from a royal family in Indonesia, and it was the largest D-color flawless Golconda diamond in the world, D-color internally flawless. And the stone was priceless. It was actually sold through Christie's, and it was sold for $21.5 million.
Now, I got to tell you, I've been a customer of yours. I've gone in there with my wife to your store. It's just truly incredible. And the reaction when people go in there, it's just mind-blowing. And most importantly, too, is that when they're holding some of these precious stones, I mean, people are just blown away. Is it like, I think, isn't there something truly magical about it?
Oh, 100%. I mean, I think that, you know, the gems basically is an emotional reaction. You put $1 million necklace on a woman, or the Archduke Joseph, which was the piece that we tried on everyone that walked in the door, because we wanted them to really understand what a $25 million diamond felt like. And of course, I mean, those are great memories, right? It's not what you say, it's not what you do, it's how you make them feel. And so when you treat someone like a queen, like a princess, like an empress, it's a wonderful thing. Now, of course, that doesn't mean that the husbands care for me that much. And, you know, I mean, you have to be very concerned about not making sure that your male clients also appreciate you as well.
Al, tell me what do you think your first generation person in your family that became a jeweler would say to you now, or think of what you're doing now, because you've taken it so far.
Well, you know, we bring the world to our marketplace. In other words, we have 40 partners throughout the world that actually are in constant search of unique pieces, one-of-a-kind pieces. And I think that my ancestors would be very, very happy. But, you know, the interesting thing about my business is that my family lost everything in Cuba, and we came in as Catholic refugees. We were put up at the Wilson Hotel. We had absolutely nothing but just tropical clothing. And we met a gentleman in the lobby of that hotel, and he took us to a grocery store, bought us groceries for several weeks and warm clothing. And that act of remnant kindness is really why we believe that life is all about passing it forward. And it's a simple question. What would love do? That's a question I ask myself every day.
I love it. And you're listening to Alliance's Hero Show with me, David Kogan. And we have the CEO, Chairman Molina Fine Jewelers. You could reach Al Molina at MolinaFineJewelers.com. Of course, we'll have it on our website, Eliances.com. The only place where entrepreneurs align. Be part of the community. Go to Eliances.com. That's Eliances.com. Okay, Al, you got to divulge some secrets here. Your favorite piece of jewelry.
Well,
your favorite.
The Archduke was the finest stone that I ever had the honor to represent. We have sold very important rubies. I love Burmese rubies. I love red diamonds. I love blue diamonds. There isn't a jewel I've ever seen that I don't like. So, I mean, that's a very tough question for me.
And I've been to your website and, again, your store. You have a number of rules to really for success. Share with us just maybe two or three of those rules for success.
Well, I have my 17 rules of success that I actually look at every year and update. I think that the key as far as success is AMC. Attitude, motivation, and commitment. I think those are the three key factors for true success in today's world. I think that you have to remember that faith and resilience is the same word. So you have to just keep fighting the battles and just remember that, anxiety is imagining a negative outcome. Excitement is imagining a positive outcome. I mean, you know, you just have to stay positive, and that's the key, I think, to survive in business, because businesses is challenging. I mean, you know, life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans. Now, my favorite one, though, I must say, is rule number 16: to get milk from a cow, you don't send her a letter.
Oh, my gosh. Amazing. Amazing. Al, you know what I find truly, though, about your places is that, you know, and I've been to other jewelry stores and stuff. It's an experience when you go there.
Absolutely.
You make it an experience.
Absolutely.
And if you were talking to grade school children and stuff, how would you describe as far as, you know, who, you know, maybe they're in sixth grade now and, you know, they want to be able to make some money to buy toys and stuff of that. What would you share with them, maybe some secrets to being successful and to maybe do something that creates that experience? Because that's what it is. I don't even like calling it a jewelry store. It's an experience.
Well, first of all, you're not coming into a store. You're not coming into you're coming into our home. And it's you'll be treated like our best friend that just walked in the door. We will obviously exceed your expectations. You know, you have to develop relationships. First, you have to create trust. Then you need to identify their needs, not your needs. Then you're going to tell them how you're going to exceed those needs, and then you're going to create urgency. And that's easy for us to do because there's only one of that specific diamond. There's only one of that specific ruby. So for us with kids, I give away and have continue and will continue to give away thousands of books called Rhinoceros Success. And what I teach kids is to be a rhino, to be thick-skinned, to charge, to damn the torpedoes, to associate with the doers, the winners, never give up, never surrender. So those are the things that I talk to with kids and constantly try to teach them my values. You know, I have three life philosophies that I practice every day. Everything happens for a good reason. Nothing has any meaning except the meaning I give it. And on the other side of tremendous frustration is tremendous success. And those philosophies is what keeps me sane. Because no matter how challenging a day may be, if I believe in those three philosophies, there is no such thing as a bad day.
Well, I got to tell you, you believe that definitely that every individual is a precious jewel too. And it's in our commitment and social responsibility to ensure that they become brilliant. That's a Hero. Al Molina, you can reach him at MolinaFineJewelers.com. Again, Al Molina, MolinaFineJewelers.com. And this is David Kogan with Eliances. And when we return, the co-founder of Vintage Race Card Co. and Grand Prix of Scottsdale, GrandPrixScottsdale.com.